World Cup last year, mixed teams gold. Cup finals, she's come second twice in 2021 and 2023, third in 2022. Asian Games champion in the team event last year. You feel this is the most winnable of the ones for Japan coming into it?
In terms of contest and the stage that we're at, especially as it being 1-1 at the moment, I see this as winnable for Miyu Hirano. Not probable, but winnable.
Love one.
Both similar in height, both similar in distance that they stay from the table, both similar in speed. This could go all the way, down to the wire. Two punch errors, straight away there.
Wow. You know, you look back at the final in 2018, Miyu Hirano played twice. She was the key player there. Lost to Ding Ning, 3-0, lost to Lu Shiwen, 3-0. She'd like to right those wrongs. She was only 18 then.
One advantage that non-Team China players have is that because they're not playing for as strong of a team in terms of strength and depth, they can often enter the senior stage at a younger age. Miyu Hirano's had more experience relatively than Wang Yidi to say how old she is. She was part of the Japanese team at the 2014 Asian Games. Nearly 10 years ago, it was March. Lost to China in the final. She has been here a while, Hirano, to say she's only 23.
Good start here from you, Hirano. Sun Yingsha in the practice hall at the moment. She is going to be in action later on for sure because of what happened earlier. She's talking to a coach here because of Hina Hayata. That's a deep discussion as to how to take on Hina Hayata, I'm sure.
Yeah, that's her personal coach there, Cho Yika. Well, Japan in this tie ahead. She's not on the nickname the Hurricane for no reason. She is lightning quick. The ritualistic Hirano here, 5-2 up.
No record against Chinese players, 23%, 17 wins out of 74 matches played.
Nice receive there from Wang Yidi. Guides it. Trailing by two. Shovel serve. You can see that last minute, a last second bite to that serve there.
She made a name that 2017 Asian Championships, didn't she, when she blew away three Chinese players on the way to the title.
That's right. Unbelievable achievement there.
6 years ago, she was still a 17-year-old when that happened. Still maintaining a lead, but it's only a point now. Also the youngest ever winner of the Women's World Cup. in 2016 at just 16 years of age, but then kind of lost away a little bit. Like that serve?
Yeah, another shovel. Both similar servers. There really is a lot of similarities between these two. I'd say that Wang Yidi plays a flatter backhand more often, though.
Six, seven.
Returns the favour, Wang Yidi. First time in a while, we are all square here. He's kind of talking to herself quite a bit here, Wang Yidi.
That's just the edge.
Right off that. Oh, against China, you will take all of these opportunities.
What a rally.
7-9.
Winning more than a fair share of the backhand trades here, Hirano. It's not just the speed in which she plays it, it's the speed in which she gets back to the neutral position to play the next. Jousting here.
Close, not far away. She's just sensing a chance to apply a little bit more pressure on Team China.
We haven't seen the down-the-line switch in about 20-odd shots. What a flip that was. Coming right round the side of it, Miu Hirano. Beautiful side spin there. Not much topspin, and Wang Yidi only hits air.
Two game points, Miu Hirano. She's taking the first game, Miu Hirano. And that is an excellent start to this third match. Japan go one up here. She's got self-belief, Miu Hirano. And after taking that game, 11-8. Now let's cast our minds back to the last time Japan actually won the World Champs team event. That was 1971. That was when they also beat China 3-1. This is Toshiko Kawada defeating Lin Huijing 3-1 in the final. And here you go, the coach taking the accolades. But a fine, fine moment for Japan. Boy, Fraser, you got to go all that way back, more than 50 years since they last won it.
When you were 25 years old.
I'll let you have that. I'll let you have that. Because and a lot of people would love to see Japan do it. And that would really mean a lot to me as well, 75, at the age of 75, to see Japan do it as well.
Second game, Japan to serve. Now all.
You were just a glint in the eye, weren't you? Well, Miu Hirano has got a glint in her eye. She's delighted at this start. But can she continue that momentum?
One, no.
Maybe she can. The pressure really building now on Wang Yidi. She's been so good since that loss to Sri Jakula.
It's a tough one to the Indian national champion. But here against an out-and-out attacker. I mean, let's give her, Miu Hirano her flowers. The two players that have managed to take Sun Ying Shark Claws outside of Team China were Sun Hyewon and Han Ying. Hirano was the only out-and-out attacker in recent times to beat Sun, which she did in the final of the Contenders Zagreb in Game 7.
Six of the eight gone to Miu Hirano.
She'll be aware of that, Wang Yidi. Well aware of Hirano's threat.
One, two.
Miu Hirano hadn't even played any competitive table tennis this year coming into this event.
Wow.
Certainly on the WTT stage. And then you contrast that with Wang Yidi. She's played one event. Lost in the quarterfinals. The WTT star contender Doha lost to Chen Tianyi. Lost 3-0 there.
That's a very surprising result. Especially between two players of the same team.
Wow. Wang Yidi goes in front. She dropped a game to Li Xiaolian as well, by the way.
Who she lost to in 2021, believe it or not.
She's lost, well, that's right. So I'm not sure she's necessary right at the very top at the moment of her game.
Three, all.
Certainly fairly vulnerable for a world number two.
Yeah.
But she won the Champions Frankfurt, didn't she, Wang Yidi? Got a bucket load of points for that.
Yeah, fantastic achievement. Getting into that number two. Sometimes, oh, she didn't even make the final of the last World Champ, did she? Wang Manyu was there. Edgy, this second game.
Three, five.
You know she's going to come fired up. Wang Yidi. How does what does Miu Hirano have to do?
They've both got to receive serve better. They're both catching each other out with the exact same serve, topspin shovel. Either trap the spin better to keep it tight, or flick it out.
Four, five.
Dismissive nice. Punch.
Yeah, nice punch there. Wang Yidi, quick to it.
Opens up the racket, so the edge is basically vertical and comes right through that at the peak of the bounce. You've got to time it very well because you're not using as much topspin. So there's less security there, but it's more deadly if it goes on. Mima Ito, a short pimple puncher. The Chinese will see it as a stylistic limitation. That's what, how they managed to work Mima out, and that's why perhaps Mima isn't here.
Do you think that might play into this equation?
Yeah. Mm.
Just a little hesitation
there. Replay that point. It's on a knife edge, this one, isn't it? Yidi cannot afford to go two down here. It's a tough position to be in. Mukherano needs to be firm.
And she's got some luck. And now has two serves.
Well, great position for Mukherano. Now, you're saying that the service returns have left something to be desired, is that right?
They both popped up quite a lot of shovel serves and made it easy for a decent third ball attack opportunity.
All right, let's see how Wang Yidi responds here.
Oh, it's half long.
It doesn't respond at all. They're the Japanese fans.
Game on.
Timeout called. It's a slow stroll across from Wang Yidi. It's China have asked for it.
Mima Ito's
the most vocal of them all.
Yeah. The 10 years that I spent training in Japan have allowed me to translate that, and it looked like Mima Ito was gesturing there that the Chiquita flick was working well. So I remember in the last game,
yeah,
Hirano did it and Wang Yidi fresh aired it.
Yeah, I remember that. Now, second save, second. Every point being scrapped for. This game seems like it feels like it's taken forever, isn't it? With 7-all. Now it's Wang Yidi in front. Going for these flicks. Now, let's see how Hirano returns his serve.
Ooh,
yeah, she was going for it there. Very useful 2-point cushion here. for Wang Yidi. Just put a little bit more on that, didn't she? Back and forth on that. Unbelievable. This is what hours and hours of training prepare you for. Another serve here.
Pumped up and ready to rumble.
Two game points for the Chinese paddler. Now, can she finish this and make it one all? Saves the first point there, Hirano. Motioning a lot there. Fraser, what are you thinking?
I was wondering if we were going to see another backhand to backhand rally.
Well, you got your wish. You got your wish. Hirano has saved two game points.
I mean, it's kind of amazing that we're seeing this number of them.
But she's just putting a little bit more loop into it, a little less pace, right? New Hirano?
Right, please. Thank you.
Coming at the back of the ball slightly more, but still transferring her energy forward. We've not seen that many switches, though, have we, at all?
No.
11-10.
A third game point for Wang Yidi.
Here we see it blossom into a mid-distance point, but Wang Yidi immediately centres herself at the table and gets ready to control with the backhand from the middle. And that intimidates Hirano a bit.
Well, she saved the last two game points. Can she do it for a third time?
Oh, well, she's got a few nets, hasn't she, Hirano?
That's sometimes just how it falls, and she will be absolutely delighted that this second game is somehow still alive.
My word.
What do you want to see from this serve now?
I want to see tight to forehand with topspin and then get ready to get over the ball. Ooh, well, it went into the forehand. I'll have to look at it again to see what spin was on it, but
is that a missed opportunity or not?
Well, evidently there. Wang Yidi, let's have a look. Maybe it was a bit floatier, but she snatches at the backhand punch there, doesn't she?
It looked like one that she might have put away. And all of a sudden, it's got a game point to Murana, her first one of this second game. This to go two up.
Oh, she's
kicking
it, though.
11, game to Japan.
Has taken a 2-0 lead here. Again, it might have looked like a Wang Yidi miss. Whatever it is, Miu Hirano will be so thrilled that she's won 13-11. That's second game.
Third game, China to serve, Lawol.
Wang Yidi is under tremendous pressure.
One, no.
And you've got to just think about going ahead. I know we're still about 4 or 5 months away, Fraser, but China have two spots at the Olympics. You would think it's Sun Yingsha plus another.
Clear Japan. Please don't delay the match.
Who's that going to be?
Well, do you go with your defending champion or do you go with the player that's the best at the moment?
I mean,
an Olympics is a unique event. For me at the moment, I'd be going with Sun Yingsha and Wang Manyu, which makes you think why Wang Manyu's not playing this. Maybe this is the trial of Wang Yidi. Maybe she knows that this is the opportunity to present herself, and if she doesn't, she won't get picked for that.
Well, this time she puts it away. Now, she had a couple of those sort of opportunities towards the end of the last game. There is Wang Manyu.
Because she's not won a world championships, Wang Yidi.
Yeah.
But yet she was picked for the Asian Games as well, where only two could play. She lost to Hayata there.
That's a good point. She's saying she's been handed her chances.
This is her chance.
Yeah. She's had the Asian Games. She's now in the world championships finals. She's down by two here. The real pressure, Wang Yidi. 3-1 up.
3-2.
Switched it up, didn't she, Muherano?
She's quicker than Wang Yidi.
It goes Hirano's way. The crowd didn't see that at first. And then there's a real sort of sense of disbelief amongst the spectators. I'll have that, thank you, says Hirano.
This is the second time this event, Wang Yidi's found herself 2-0 down to someone.
One of his fast and furious rallies. And in Chinese terms, that's almost unforgivable, isn't it? In the same event, to find yourself 2-0 down twice.
5-3.
She's been a bit more clinical in this third game.
depends on what your hopes are. And it depends on how the others are performing as well.
Well, you've got Chen Meng who's lost before you. You know you've been put under real pressure here.
Six, three.
This is about as big a lead as she's had in a while. Wang Yidi, 3 points.
In a final, less forgivable.
To answer my earlier point about being 2-0 down, yep.
In a final. Because that's the true catalyst, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's when the pressure's really on.
Yeah, in first match of an event,
against,
you can always put it down, you know, playing long pips and all that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Those are some mitigating reasons. But this is good right now. In this particular game, Wang Yidi would be delighted. She's up by four.
Four, seven.
Look at that for a jagged.
Is this kind of rolling back the years for you for Miu Hirano?
It is. It's so good to see. So good to see her playing in this way. And it shows that the Japanese are less sentimental with their selections than they used to be, and it's paying off.
What a winner there, Miu Hirano, on the forehand cross court.
Wow. Blistering. Look at that for an angle. Using extra waist there to create extra spin required to make that part of the table from where she was. Blooming hell, fire.
This is real pressure again now building up on Wang Yidi.
Wow!
Seven,
jabbed
six.
At that one, didn't she?
These angles here, she's stretching Wang Yidi, who is planting the feet way too heavy.
Three quick points in a row, Miu Hirano. Took that early. The pressure now really building up on Wang Yidi again. Just a point behind Hirano. Played that a little deep. Too deep for Wang Yidi.
Wow. How long has it been since we've seen the Chinese women taken to these depths in a final of a world championship?
Well, that's a credit to Wang Yidi because she was probably feeling that quite a bit. Remember, 4 points in a row.
It was Moscow, wasn't it? It was Moscow.
So, but that's when they lost.
So I guess that's the answer.
Yeah. 2010. Miracle of Moscow.
Eight on.
Again. She's only 3 points away from beating Wang Yidi 3-0 in a final.
Was gesturing to Hirano is paying off in full.
Look at this. Right now, the momentum with the Japanese players, 6 out of 8 for her.
Seven.
Well, this one on a very, very thin knife edge here, and there's lots of instructions here to Sun Ying Sha. She's up against Hina Hayata. More and more of the coaches come in and have a chat with her. There is real pressure here in Team China. Make no mistake, Hayata looking forward to that, I'm sure. Look at the pressure telling on Miwa Harimoto. She might have to play later as well. A game point for Wang Yidi.
Right, please, thank you.
That change of pace was genius. You could argue brave when you're up against a player of Wang Yidi, but she sees the logic in it, Hirano, when given barely any time to think.
She saves that game point. Remember, she saved game points as well in the previous one. Wow, and she now has a match point, Miu Hirano.
This is unbelievable.
A massive moment here. Mind you, we said that earlier today as well, didn't we? Korea against China in the men's semi-final. Miu. And that is a huge result here.
Wang Yidi has just been swept off her feet by the hurricane. Heavy rain and squall here on Team China.
Miu Hirano has beaten Wang Yidi 11-8, 13-11, 12-10. She's beaten her 3-0, the world number two. Are we on the brink of something very, very special? Japan.